With season 11 fast approaching, it's now time for us to take a look at some of the preparation we should be doing to get ready for next season. In this video today, we're going to take a look at some of the systematic changes coming to Destiny 2, but also some of the weapons and things you should be doing to get yourself ready. Now, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a rating down below. That super helps me out here on the channel. And if you are new around here and want to keep up to date with all the latest Destiny 2 content, then be sure to hit subscribe as well. But without further delay, guys, let's jump into the video. So each and every season we get a brand new seasonal artifact. Back in season 8 we got the Lantern of Osiris, and the idea behind the artifacts is not only to increase our power as a guardian but also to provide seasonal modifications that we can apply to our weapons and armor to help adjust our playstyles for the up and coming season. Now in Season of the Worthy we got Warmind Khanjali as the seasonal artifact. This worked in exactly the same way as it did in previous seasons, and a good example is by looking at some of the mods that we got this season really heavily focused around swords and some of the changes that Bungie implemented to those this season as well. Now the season of the Redacted is likely to be exactly the same, but before we get into details around the artifact and the season pass, be sure to take a look at your collections first of all and have a look at the mods you've been gathering over the last couple of seasons. There are some immensely strong mods, not just for the current season with all the Warmind, but also from the previous season, from the Season of Dawn. Now if you don't have all the Warmind mods, you can get these from the bunkers directly. If you level them up, you can purchase two from each of the bunkers, and the rest you can get from random drops by completing the Seraph Tower public event. So whilst the mods are available, be sure to take advantage of that. If you don't have any of the seasonal mods from Season of Dawn, be sure to keep checking in on Banshee 44 over in the tower. He sells these on the odd occasion, and these are some of the most powerful mods in the game, and they will still be applicable going into next season, so be sure to maximize those opportunities when they present themselves. Now one of the first things you may want to do in the final week of the season is take a look at some of the Warmind bits that you've been stacking all season in the hope that they may offer a new bunker for us to upgrade. If that is not the case, then you'll probably have a couple of thousand like I have, and if that is the case, then be sure to convert these into chipsets which you can use to then level up the bunkers. Whilst leveling up the bunker won't provide any meaningful benefit in terms of influencing the game, it will provide you rewards which you can then dismantle for materials, and this will provide you with legendary shards in return for the ones that you spend, but also the chance of getting enhancement cores as well. And these will be key materials for you going into the new season, as they always are, but they also mean that all the materials that you've been collecting all season don't go to waste too. Now another thing to bear in mind going into next season is we're going to start seeing the first steps of sunsetting. This won't come into effect until season 12. However, there are things we can do now and next season to make sure we are set for season 12 when that becomes available later this fall. Now a key thing to remember is that weapons and armor for Last Wish and Garden of Salvation Rage will be granted exceptions to this and will have higher max power levels than any other legendary weapon or armor piece in the game. Now the max power level for these items will be visible in the game in season 11, but no item will be at their max power level at the start of that season. So this means that all your gear will still be relevant for all activities during season 11. So any gear you got from season 9, 10, 11 or the up and coming season 12 will still be infusible to the new power cap for 1 year after their initial release. So this is why raid armor and weapons are super important, because these yield an exception to that and will have a higher max power cap as a result of that. So any high stat armor you can get from those raids or really good well-rolled weapons will serve you very well over the up and coming year, as they'll be excluded from any power caps that may be in place. So from now and throughout the up and coming season, be sure to maximize your raid opportunities to give yourself the best opportunity to get as many high stat armor rolls as you possibly can and any very well rolled weapons that you can take on into year 4 of Destiny 2. Now in Bungie's recent update, they talked about some of the archetype buffs coming in season 11, and one of those was in regards to bows. Now there are some fantastic bows within each of these raids, as you can see, and bows are underused in challenging content. So Bungie are going to be buffing these in season 11 and providing a plus 10% to any PvE damage versus minor adds. So if you're thinking about experimenting with bows, then be sure to farm out for a Tyranny of Heaven or the Accrued Redemption from each of these raids and give them a try. I mean, a plus 10% buff with Dragonfly on the Tyranny of Heaven is a very strong bow indeed, and will be interesting to see exactly how effective they will now be in challenging content. Now, bows aren't the only weapon archetype getting a pass in Season 11. Slug shotguns are also underused in PvE because they require crits to maximize their damage, and they don't reward that precision with a higher damage per second. So as a result, Bungie are buffing these as well, providing a plus 30% to their PvE damage. Now, another fantastic example that falls within the raids we've been talking about is Prophet of Doom. This is a precision frame slug shotgun from the Garden of Salvation raid, and this can get some pretty filthy rolls on it. This is the one that I have. Not only does this weapon have insane range, it also has slideways, and as you can see, 1-2 punch. So by hitting an enemy with every bullet in a shot, increases your melee damage for a short duration. So when you stack that on top of the buff that slug shotguns are going to get, weapons like this are going to be very strong from Season 11 onwards. Now, a few other slug shotguns to bear in mind, although these will fall outside the raid specifically, is the Good Bone Structure. You can get this from the gunsmith over in the tower, but you can get some great rolls on this shotgun. It comes with snapshot and quick draw as a possible roll, and this will be very strong in both PvE and PvP. Another fan favorite is the Retold Tale. Again, a precision slug shotgun, which can get some incredible rolls and is a favorite, especially inside the Crucible. If you complete your Oracle Offering and any of the missions within the Dreaming City each week, you have a chance to get this weapon drop. And the last, by no means least, is the Gunora's Axe. We'll need to wait for Iron Banner to come back around for this one, but again, some incredible rolls, as you can see, available inside the Crucible. But this will be a great shotgun to try out in PvE once the buff lands in Season 11. And the final archetype that we know is getting a pass in Season 11 is high impact pulse rifles. These are underused in Crucible as well, and they have a very fast optimal time to kill, but it is one that is hard to achieve, so Bungie have decided to soft that a little bit for us. So high impact pulse rifles damage per bullet will go from 21 to 22, so a subtle change. That will mean instead of getting 6 crits, you will now need only 5 crits and 1 body to kill a guardian in PvP across most resilience values. And with that in mind, Redric's broadsword is lined up to be an absolute monster in Crucible come Season 11. So if you haven't completed the quest for your broadsword and got one with Outlaw and Desperado, be sure to take the time that you've got between now and the start of next season to finish this quest to make sure you're set to go once this update lands. So that summarizes all the systematic and sandbox changes coming in Season 11. But as always, there is more we can do to make sure we are ready, and this comes in the form of XP. Now, each and every season, there's a plethora of bounties that we tried to complete to carry over from one season to the next. So we're just going to cover those off once again, and also a couple of the other steps that you can take whilst you're doing this to maximize your XP gains going into next season. Now, the easiest one to do, but also the easiest one to forget, is getting a 10% guided light ghost. If you participated in the Guardian games, then you probably might have 3 of these across your characters. So be sure to make sure these are equipped before you hand in any bounties next season. Now, alongside that, you can also get a plus 20% premium season track from your level 1 rank up, but also you'll get plus 2% XP bonuses throughout the premium season track as well. Now, to maximize your gains, you can also make sure you are part of a fire team when handing in any of your bounties. This will make sure you get the fire team bonus, which is also available in order to maximize your XP gains. Now, there is a method to the madness that is bounties, and all in all, you can carry 63 per character. Now, in terms of prioritizing certain bounties, first of all, you need to grab all of the weekly bounties that you possibly can and complete and hold these in your inventory. Now, the weekly bounties will provide 12,000 XP going into the new season. That is the minimum they'll provide. All your bonuses will stack on top of that. So make sure that you can complete as many as you possibly can. Once you've completed as many weeklies, then you can move on to dailies. These will provide 6,000 as a base amount of XP. Again, this will only increase once you include all the benefits we mentioned earlier. And after that, you can move on to the planetary bounties. These provide 4,000 in XP. Again, this will only increase when you include the bonuses. And finally, a few things to recommend is avoid any infamy or valor bounties, as this has been known to mess with the first powerful rank up engram of the new season. Alongside that, avoid any Petra or Spider bounties, as these offer the lowest XP currently available from a planetary bounty. Now, Sweatsicle from Redeem has created an insane spreadsheet which helps you track all the bounties that you're collecting and the XP that you're earning going into next season, but also exactly how much each bounty rewards you, including all the bonuses that we've mentioned in this video. So I'll leave a link to that spreadsheet in the video description below. Be sure to go use it if you wish, and I'll leave a link to Sweatsicle's YouTube channel also in the video description below. So there we have it, guys. That is everything we need to know ahead of season 11. That is all the systematic, sandbox, and prep that we can do to get ourselves ready. If you have enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a rating down below. That super helps me out here on the channel. And if you are new around here and want to keep up to date with all the latest Destiny 2 content, be sure to hit subscribe as well. I'm going to jump back into the game as always, guys, but I will catch you all again very soon.